Vanishing Point, a novel by Keith A. Kennell, 14 of 101. Part 14. The wall clock in Stacy Shannon's third grade classroom read 4:03, and only she, Sarah Conan, and Skylar Kaiser remained in the room. Sarah was visibly agitated, and Miss Shannon was confident that the little girl was concerned that her mother would chastise her for having remained inside Interlochen School a third of an hour after dismissal time. "Girls," she asked her two students, "sorry to keep you till the very last, but I wanted to speak to your mother, Sarah. I waited until everyone else was dismissed before releasing you so I could come out with you and have a little chat with her." Stacy's brow knitted in surprise at Sarah's mouth opened, eyes widened, and shoulders drooped response. "Oh," she said quickly, assessing the girl's nonverbal response, "you haven't done anything wrong. I just wanted to mention Skylar's strange playground sightings, that's all. If you're ready, we'll go find your mom, and then you two can head off to your overnight together." Sarah's immediate release of tension was obvious as she declared, "When you said that I was afraid I'd done something wrong. Skylar, you ready?" Skylar brought up her right cheek in a crooked grin and declared, "Sure am. Let's get this shoe on the road." Miss Shannon tilted her head to the side, looked down at Skylar, and asked, Did you say shoe, Skylar? Are you sure you didn't mean show on the road?" Skylar retracted her head in response, brought her eyebrows together, and replied, "Show? Miss Shannon, I don't mean to sass you, but that doesn't make a lick of sense. We don't put shows on the road. We put shows on TV. We put shoes on the road. Everybody knows that. Sometimes you say the strangest things. No offense, ma'am." Stacy began to respond with an explanation of the idiom's origin, immediately changed her mind, and instead smiled and said, "None taken. Now, let's go find Mrs. Marty. Oh, and Skylar," she continued, pulling the slip of paper with Caleb Ezra Morris's name written on it, "remind me of your mother's phone so I don't have to look it up. I may want to call her, too." Skylar recited her mother's phone number quickly, and Stacy added it to the paper with Caleb's name before proceeding to the front of the school with her two students. Marty Hofer Conan, having changed from tight, revealing workout clothes to a tight and more revealing mini dress, stood by the nearly empty bike rack in a mouth puckered, nostrils flaring, arms clenched under her silicone augmented breasts, declaration of impatient wrath. Upon seeing her stepdaughter accompanied by Miss Shannon, the woman's barely contained, scornful ire surfaced with an indignant, "Goodness gracious, Sarah Ann Conan, what have you done this time? Miss Shannon, whatever's going on here?" Stacy bent her right arm at the elbow and held her hand palm facing forward at waist level. "I'm sorry to make you wait, Miss Conan," she replied quickly. "Sarah hasn't done anything wrong." Marty's body clutching arm shot outward so that her now bald fists of hands rested aggressively on the lean fit hips of her wide stance belligerent pose. "Oh my God, so what? It's Skylar's, for God's sake? Sarah, this is exactly what I was talking about this morning." Stacy, the two third graders hiding in her shadow, walked closer to Marty, right hand pivoting left and right at her wrist in negation of the other woman's anger. No, Mrs. Conan. No one's done anything wrong. There was just a little odd circumstance today on the playground that I wanted to alert you to. Nothing to worry about. Just, well, a stranger who Sarah and Skylar saw loitering around the playground during recess. He reminded Skylar of her father. That's all. I just wanted to inform you before you took the girls home in case either of them mentioned it to you. It was probably nothing, but we had an incident report filed. In poorly contained hostility, Marty responded staccato styling, declaring, "You are kidding me, right?" And then shaking her head added, "And for this you've had me cooling my heels in the sweltering heat for over 10 minutes? Ridiculous!"